Alright guys, so I went over deficit deadlifts. So as you saw, I had plates on there. Now I put four of them, so that way it gets the whole length of my foot. As far as the width or diameter of the plate, diameter doesn't really matter. The width, the thicker, the more you're in a deficit by how much thicker it is, then the harder it's gonna be. Now, I would suggest starting out at a low deficit, right? Not such a big one, right? So if you put a 45-pound plate, depending on the thickness of the plate that is in your gym or wherever you have them available, it's gonna make a difference, right? So make sure you're aware of that. Sometimes you have to stack them together. Be careful on stacking metal plates together. They're gonna slip, they're gonna be slippery. So find a way to create a deficit. Whatever it is, make sure you're safe with it. You can use boxes. I've seen people use books. Whatever it is, make sure it's something that is sturdy, but also doesn't make you lose power. Like a book won't be as good as maybe some wooden surface. Now, the purpose of a deficit deadlift is to increase your bottom pull, the initial pull from the ground. Now, if you have trouble, this is gonna help you increase that strength through that by increasing more tension on certain muscles. Now, there is debate that deficits are bad for you, etc. Well, you know, you should try them out, right? Keep in mind that usually you're not gonna be doing your full weight of what you normally do from the ground, right? When you're in a deficit, think of it as a 10 pound or 10% at minimum decrease from your PR, right? So keep that in mind. Another thing to be careful with is when you are in a deficit, if you don't have much mobility or you have trouble with mobility, it's gonna be even harder to create that proper mechanic if you have tightness in your hip flexors, your hamstrings, etc. That leaves you to pull incorrectly in the first place. So make sure you get a lot of stretching and you practice. Video yourself so that way you can see it from the side of how your lower back, if it dips. So kind of like doing a butt wink, but on a deadlift, which is your hips, your lumbar spine, kind of like anterior or posterior tilts. So it like tucks under you. So that's gonna leave a little round on your lower back, which you do not want, right? Takes away the tension from the hamstrings, puts on your lumbar spine, something that you don't wanna do. Now, start with a light load and then progress your way up. So keep that in mind. So give those a try. If you guys have any questions, you could email me at ecfitlife@gmail.com. Facebook, Instagram, those are some of the social media sites you can find me at Easy Fitness Life, or go ahead and comment on this video here. I hope that helps. Like I said, if you guys have any questions, keep in touch. Take care, guys.